Well, from television production now to retail advertising, and South Africa's first ever retail advertising conference has just taken place here in Johannesburg. So what is retail advertising and why is it important in the broader communications mix? The classic definition, as I understand it, is advertising which promotes local merchandisers, goods and services. Sounds a bit boring, but is it? We have two expert guests with us today. Ruby Anik, Senior Vice President Brand Marketing at JCPenney, that's the big US department store. And with her is Mike Gatti, Executive Director, Retail Advertising and Marketing Association, based in Washington, D.C. Folks, welcome to you. I'm sure you disagreed with my intro. The impression one gets is that it's the boring and the necessary part of brand communications. I'm sure, Ruby, you'll make a case for it, though.
I definitely disagree with you. I have spent much of my career in packaged goods, or FMCG, in the last 10 years in retail, and I've never had a more exciting time. And the reason I disagree is that branding, the choice of why JCPenney or why another department store, is what we focus most of our time on. And local promotions, though they drive weekend sales, don't build a long-term emotional loyalty, what we call loyalty beyond reason, and this connection, this emotional bond that will keep our consumer coming back to us time and time again. So branding is really where we focus a lot of our time on, even though we have to do the necessary promotional weekend advertising. And I focus personally a lot of time on why JCP, why JCPenney, and why do I need to give my consumers a reason to choose us over another department store.
Mike, there's no such a thing these days, though, as consumer loyalty, is there?
No, there's not. The consumer is fickle. They go where they can get the best deal. But it's important, retailers spend a lot of time building a relationship with their customer. And, you know, it does start to become about the brand. A lot of retailers now offer private label. It's merchandise that you can't get at any other store. So we're starting to see where consumers are becoming more loyal to certain brands because of that.
Ruby, in terms of building that customer loyalty, what do we as customers actually want from the relationship?
I would put it into two categories. First, we need to understand what your need is, and better than anybody else. And then we need to fulfill that need from a merchandise standpoint. What Mike said is very true. We spend a lot of time building our private brands. We call them our power brands. 45% of what we sell in the store is our private brands. We focus a lot of time and energy in building our in-house design groups. We source directly from 41 countries. And our back to school, which is happening right now, we have introduced 6 new private brands. 2 of our power brands give us $1 billion in sales. So that's one thing. The second reason is to really understand beyond any of our competitors why they come to us. And the reason that they come to JCPenney is it's style and price, smart prices. So we are able to give them the style, and by style I mean fashion, design, based on their needs, and then give it to them and give them smart prices so that they don't go to a Macy's or they don't go to a Nordstrom's, because they can get the style and quality with us, but we can meet their budgets.
There's a third element to that, isn't there? And that's consistency of experience when the customer enters the store.
That's true. You know, when it comes to customer experience, how they're treated in the store, how they view your store, it's all about making sure that you're authentic towards your customer. So you position your brand in a certain way, you offer a certain type of merchandise, and then you engage your customer. And if they, it's really about believability. So as long as they believe that you're offering what you say, then you're going to gain that customer.
I'm a little skeptical about this power brand notion. It's often seen as the non-sexy part, that labels are far more important. How do you make the case for in-house labels?
You know, it's the proof is in the pudding. We do sell our national brands, and we do have obviously a big stake in that. But our power brands have proven very, very successful for us.
Because they're cheaper?
No, because they're based on the needs of the customer. We spend, our design group and us in marketing, we work very closely together, and we spend hours and hours talking to customers, not just focus groups, but doing ethnographies, shopping with them, going to their homes. And our power brands really are the point of differentiation, because anybody can get a Levi's jean at a Kohl's or a Macy's, but but they cannot get some of our power brands, our Worthingtons, our Staffords, anywhere else. So I really don't believe, I mean, I've been in the department store business for a little over a year, and I don't believe it's a myth because I've seen it work. Now, I do agree with you. If you're just going to churn out brands because it makes you feel better, then I think you're going to fail. But if it's based on the need of the customer and understanding that specialness that we can provide and the quality, I think that's it's a key point of differentiation.
Well, Mike, if I can interject, in addition to what Ruby's talking about, you know, when you think about private label brands, don't think generic. You know, because it's not about generic. They have partnered with celebrities, they partner with rock stars, and they build brands like that. And these are people that, you know, the consumer emulates towards, so they are definitely willing to come in and buy those products. And that's really where the success
comes
in.
Are those power brands then that are well marketed, as obviously JCP is doing, giving the more established brands a hiding these days?
In our case, I think our power brands are giving a run for the money with some of our national brands. And power brands, to Mike's point, we can put in two different areas. One is the ones we design with some of the famous designers like a Nicole Miller or a Liz & Co. And then we have power brands that we develop that are exclusive to us. They're not generic. They have brand profiles, they have personalities, and they live and breathe as a pure brand. And it's only available at JCPenney.
So. Folks, time's against us. I want to ask you each one question. You can both have a stab at it. How creative can you get in the discipline of retail advertising? Is creativity important?
It's very important. You can get extremely creative, and that's really, you know, you're competing with all of the other industries out there when you are vying for attention from the consumer. So absolutely, you can go all the way to the edge, and it really depends on who's your target audience. So age groups and you know, different parts of the country attract different creative.
Oh, I think it's all about the creative. I showed all our advertising yesterday, and I had people who came up to me later and said they had tears in their eyes, it got them in their heart, and we win awards. It is not promotional price point advertising. It is about pure creativity, again, based on understanding the need of the customer.
Folks, enjoy the trip to Cape Town. You're going to love it.
Thank you.
And just ahead on Mags on Media this week, why we like the new UK Wonderbra ad and the launch of a global version of the board game Monopoly.
We'll be right back.